Hey, how y'all doing out there? I'm back with you with another video. Today I just want to do a quick video on why I'm sticking with my OnePlus 7T Pro. Now I have been really thinking, very hard about, upgrading to the OnePlus 8 Pro because it had a lot of things on that phone that I've been waiting for OnePlus to get for a long time, like 120 hertz refresh rate, better cameras, louder speaker, 30 watt wireless charging, finally getting wireless charging, reverse wireless charging. Of course, you get a Snapdragon 865, you get a brighter display, a bigger battery at 4,510 milliamps, and IP68 water and dust resistance. Now, all that sounds really great. It's actually a justifiable upgrade if you're considering upgrading. Now, if you're coming from an older OnePlus device, I say it makes sense. Like if you're coming from the OnePlus 5 or the OnePlus 6 or the OnePlus 4 or something that old, then it makes sense to go to the 8 Pro. But for me, from going from the 7T Pro to the 8 Pro, even though I was really considering it, I just can't, I don't know. For me, I just don't need it. Like, and it's not that it's not a great phone, sure it is, but I like the width of this phone, and the OnePlus 8 Pro is a little narrower, and I like phones with a little more width to it. The thing I like about this phone also, it has a Quad HD 90 hertz AMOLED fluid display, HDR 10 plus, and it's all display. Look at this, there's no punch hole. Now with the 8 Pro and the 9 Pro, you get the little punch hole in the left side, and I know that don't bother everybody, but when you can finally get a phone that has nothing in the front at all, on the top or the bottom, you just got all display, no bezels at all, you kind of like don't want to get that up. And the pop-up selfie camera, I don't have to use it if I don't want to. Of course, it's equipped with, face unlock, which is cool, but I don't have to use it. I can use the optical fingerprint sensor, which is also excellent. I think they probably make the best fingerprint sensor, or one of the best. So I'm cool. Like, the performance of this device is really great. I have no issues at all. It's nice and fast. It's nice and smooth. Like they said, the fluid display, no issues. The battery life on this device is excellent. 2 days easily. When I don't use the device, if I'm using it light and I just keep it on, this phone literally has lasted me 9 days. Seriously, the standby time is unbelievable. Just like LG always had excellent standby time, but OnePlus standby time is better. Now, with this phone, it's just so much about it. I like the dual stereo speakers are not the best, but they sound really good. They're adequate, okay? They're not terrible, but, they just lack a little fullness of sound. But other than that, they sound great. I have no problem with it. I love the 30-watt warp charging. And like I said, the performance, you got the Snapdragon 855 Plus. There's no lag on this phone. It's super smooth and super fast. Seriously, like no issues whatsoever. Like none. I've had no issues. The only thing I'll say that had disappointed me about OnePlus of late is that, the updates have been really slow. And they used to be pretty timely when it comes to software updates, but they've been relatively slow the last year or so, and I don't know why. They used to always get the latest version of Android shortly after Google, but I don't know what's been going on recently. They've just been really late and really slow, so I hope they pick that up. Also, I forgot to mention, with the 8 Pro, you're getting an always-on display. Now, for some reason, the always-on display didn't reach this phone, and that's a really great disappointment, because that's something I was looking forward to. I really was, with the newer update from OnePlus. So when I didn't get that, I was extremely disappointed, because always on display is what I've been waiting for on OnePlus devices for years. Now now with the 8 Pro, you're going to get it, and of course with the 9 Pro, but for some reason I'm not able to get it on this device. It's still the ambient, when you raise the phone you can see the display, but it won't stay on. So I don't know why they did that, but unless something's wrong with my unit, but that's that's the way it is. Now with the 9 Pro, of course, we know it's mostly all about the cameras, the new design, the 65-watt wired charging, the 50-watt wireless charging, and of course, all the things I mentioned that the 8 Pro has, the 9 Pro has, but slightly upgraded. So there's always going to be upgrades, and I'm not trying to convince anybody if you have this phone that you shouldn't upgrade to the 8 Pro or the 9 Pro. I'm not telling you that. I'm just trying to explain to you why I'm not doing it, because I just don't feel like it's necessary. Now, if you're big on camera performance, then I think you should upgrade to the 8 Pro or the 9 Pro, because their cameras are vastly improved from this phone. But since I have other phones that have great cameras, I don't necessarily need the camera on this phone to be great. Now, it's good, you know, but it's not great. You know, it's not flagship quality, but it is good. You know, it's not trash. It's not, you know, real bad. It's good, but it's just not at the level that I would like, you know, if I wanted to use the camera on a regular. But of course, outside in bright sunlight, you're going to get great shots. Of course, you know, when you talk about low lights, not that great, you know, and, you know, the zoom is not that much. So it's not a bad camera, but it's not up there with the better cameras like the 8 Pro, 9 Pro, the S21, the Note 10 Plus, you know, Pixel, iPhone. Those cameras are all better. But like I said, I don't need it for the camera. I love this phone mostly for the display, the performance, the speakers, and the battery life. Those are the things I love about this phone the most. Those things right there. Because performance is just bananas. It's just so fast and so silky smooth. The battery life is crazy. And I love the display, that Quad HD display at 90 hertz. And I run it at 100% brightness. Now, with 100% brightness, I'm getting battery life easily 2 days. Easily. And if I use a light to medium, I can get 3 days. That's with 100% brightness at Quad HD resolution with 90 hertz. That's how great the battery life is on this device. It's awesome. So that's the reason why I'm sticking with the OnePlus 7T Pro. I just don't feel the need to upgrade to the 8 Pro or the 9 Pro. Of course, with the 9 Pro, like I said, you got a whole different design. This design and the 8 Pro are similar. But with the 9 Pro, you're getting a whole different design. And of course, like I said, you're getting bumped up specs. But for me, I just don't think it's necessary. I mean, you got a great display. You got a great fingerprint sensor. Great face unlock. Great battery life. Great speakers. I mean, to me, you're good if you have this. You're really good. Or either the 7 Pro. Because the 7 Pro and the 7T Pro is not that much different, except think for a camera or something in the processor. That's it. Only two changes. All right, so that was the reason why I'm sticking with my OnePlus 7T Pro. Also, keep in mind, the OnePlus 7 Pro, you can find it for just a little over $300 now. So it's crazy cheaper than the 8 Pro and the 9 Pro. For those of you that are thinking about, you know, checking out the OnePlus phones. I'm going to tell y'all right now, I know they don't advertise in this country. They should. But I'm telling you, if you get a OnePlus phone, you're going to be happy. OxygenOS is awesome. It's highly customizable. And I'm telling you, the performance, the battery life, the display, and all the things I mentioned on this phone are absolutely bananas. This is a great, great phone. If you get this phone, it's going to be good for years. Literally years. All right? All right. Thank you for taking the time to watch this content. I do appreciate it. Please leave me a thumbs up and subscribe if you want to see more content like this. Press the bell notification so you'll be notified every time I upload a new video. Thank you very much for taking the time. A big thank you to all my subscribers, and I'll check you guys out in the next one. Peace.